Okay guys, so welcome to Elysium. This is the multiplayer map. Now this is where you're going to spawn. Someone has built this wonderful little hut, which is quite convenient for any new person spawning in, you know, somewhere to hide if it's nighttime. I must say, my personal favourite thing about this hut is the unprocessed windows. They truly do harken back to an age when man had not discovered glass. Now, these pillars are they're over mob spawners. We've done a little bit of investigation, digging around in the mines near the spawn point, and we've found a fair few mob spawners. That's just down to the seed of the world, which is really good. We found it online and decided this is the one we're going to go for. So we're going to leave those mob spawners in place because we're going to do some monster hunts and stuff. Get a bunch of people together, go down in the mine shafts, and smash some monsters up a little bit. Someone has built a mine shaft near the beginning of the map, so we're gonna have a little look and see what's down here. Someone's been busy, and there you go. Oh, there we are. That's a perfect example. There's two mob spawners right next to each other in a mine shaft. So that's the sort of thing we're looking for. So we can do our monster hunts and we can go around and we can have a bit of fun. Just come back up to the light. Now, like I say, this is the spawn area. You've got a town in front of you. You've got these pillars and everything like that. So what you want to do, if you want to find players and things, you want to head for the direct center of the map. You're in the bottom left when you spawn, somewhere in the bottom left region. So you want to head for the direct center. Now I'm going to cheat a little bit and fly around just because I can. Whenever I'm playing, you may notice that all I do is just fly around, but it's your world. It's your world, guys. You know, it's your community project. You guys can build whatever you like and do whatever you like. So, center of the map, you find this wonderful town. This is the one thing that I've built that is to help you guys. It's a haven, in a very stereotypical way. So yeah, coming in, you've got the Elysium rules. These are the rules for the world that you're playing on. Obviously, leave the mob spawners, because we want to use them for monster hunts. We can use them for drops and things. These two are very similar. You know, don't take other players' items and resources. If you see a half-built house, just you leave it alone. If you see that someone's been building and there's a chest near there, don't help yourself to the stuff in there. You know, there's plenty of resources to go around. And equally, don't blow up people's houses and steal things from the houses and all that sort of stuff. Those two just, you know, griefing. Any griefing and you will be gone. No, we don't have time for people that aren't going to join in. And obviously, that leads us on to the golden rule. Try not to be a jerk. Golden rule, rule number one. You're going to make a lot more friends. There's a lot of friendly mods. We've got friendly players. You know, we've got a lot of people on here that are good fun. They're good to play with, so. Community projects. This is something, if you want to do something with a bunch of people, then stick it up here. Obviously, anyone can put a sign up. I've put a thing up for a railway. Just put what your project is and your gamer tag. So, bird's eye view. This is Haven. It's got a few buildings, so we're going to go around quickly and I'll let you know what's in each of them. You've got the workshop, crafted tables, furnaces. Anybody can use these. There are multiples of stuff. That's just for effect more than anything. Obviously, everybody can jump on the same thing. That's fine, but it's just to make it look good. You've got the brewery. Someone's been making some potions here. Let's have a little look and see what. Mundane potion. Okay, well, fair enough. It's a start. We're going to stick a few more cauldrons in there. Again, just for effect, really. So, go around to the next building, which. Make sure I shut the doors. We don't want anybody wandering about. We don't want any pigs wandering into our brewer's den and getting drunk. So we've got the enchanter's den. Work in progress. We're going to put a lot more bookshelves up the sides here. And obviously, maybe a couple more enchanting tables just for people to use when they need it. Then you've got the farm. At the moment, a sugarcane and wheat farm. Obviously, you saw the sign there. If you take anything, then just plant it back. And if you can take the sugarcanes, leave the bottom bit and then it'll just grow back on its own. Other people can use it for making books and bookshelves and enchantment things and all that sort of stuff. We got our nether portal due to a lucky find with diamonds quite early in the game. We've managed to get some obsidian and yeah, a few people have been through there getting a few bits and pieces. Now this is a chicken farm. I can't be sure, but I think this was Sniper Bunny that did this. It was just a normal chicken farm, but we wanted something a little bit more compact. So ignoring all EU regulations, Sniper Bunny rather, has stuck these chickens in a hole, filled it with water, and just let their eggs drop indefinitely. So we can all have some cake, which is fine. Don't worry about the chickens, they'll be alright. You've got the dormitory. Again, a few too many beds, but you know, it's for the effect. It's communal areas that everybody can come to. Everybody can have a little kip. Get ready for a monster hunt. You know, get geared up, get ready to go. You got your infinite water source in the middle of the town. Obviously, looks quite nice, but also it's there to help people if they're building stuff and need some water. And finally, the keystone of Haven. This is why it's here. It's community use area. It's the repository. We've got chests for every type of item. And as you can see, the sign there that I just looked at is take an item, leave an item. So if you're going to take a pickaxe, you know, take one, that's fine. Replace it with something else. In any of the chests, you can replace it with a sword or you can put anything in any of these. You've got a chest full of dirt. That's just for storage, really, more than anything else. You've got your stone products. You've got your sand and glass. Somebody's raided that and left one pane. All your wood stuff, your signs, fences, all that sort of stuff. Anything else goes in here, so we've got some netherrack in there, and then any other building materials, you know, will go in there. Plants, saplings, seeds, vegetables, flowers, all of that. Anything that grows, chuck that in that one. Got your food, cooked and uncooked. Again, help yourself, cook it yourself or not, I don't know. Just chuck these eggs in there. Animal monster drops. This is passive and aggressive mobs. So you got your wool and your leather, but then you've also got your rotten flesh and your bones and stuff as well. It all just chuck it all in the same one. And then anything else, really, just anything else that's left over. You got lapis, glowstones, there's a bed, you know, you got redstone in there, some paper. Someone has been doing some brewing, which is quite cool, and there you go, they've left it in there. And someone's made some leather armor as well for new players. It looks like it's one previous owner by the look of it, but still, anything is appreciated. As to, you know, anything you can chuck in there is great. And then if you need anything, you know where to find it. So, that's the centre of the map. We're going to have a quick little look and see what other people have been doing on here. We haven't had the map up for a long time, really, yet. There hasn't been a lot of chance for people to really show off what they can do. So, we've just got a few basic projects. You know, a few starter projects, rather. You know, I don't want to call anything basic. I don't know as to whether people are finished with it or not. Let's check the sun. Yeah, we should be alright. So, we have the Razamid, built by Razius himself. This is, I've seen him go in and out of the nether multiple times to get the materials for this. I think, essentially, he couldn't find any coal to begin with, so he used netherrack as his light source. But this moat does work quite well. Monsters will try and wander into his house and will burn, and then you can just come out and... Hello, Mr. Pig. You can just come out and pick up their drops, which is quite handy, actually. There's some sort of pig invading his house, but that, I'm sure that'd be fine. It might be his pet, I suppose. Big hole. Now, yeah, I'm assuming there's going to be a bit more stuff down in here. He's got his own little mine shaft down there. We're not going to go down there. I think that leads to a big ravine, if I remember correctly. And then this top bit is going to be coated with nether bricks and turned into a tower overlooking Haven and stuff there. That is an aborted attempt at a mob spawner that I tried. I don't fully understand the mechanics of it, so I've kind of left it half finished. I had a bit of fun and broke it a little bit, but I'm going to leave that there. Hopefully someone else will pick it up and finish it off, someone with a little bit more skill than me. So we've got, this is the first house that was built. This is Sniper Bonnie's house. It's just, again, it's just a straightforward little house. I'm assuming there's going to be some big projects going on. He's going to expand it, you know, all that sort of stuff. He's got his underground cow farm, as you do. That's you know, the most natural habitat for cows, I suppose. And the mineshaft. I'm not going to go all the way down because it looks quite big. But yeah, everybody seems to be digging under their houses, which is a common tactic. It makes sense. So coming out of here, you'll notice that there's not a lot of sand and ice on this map. It is all concentrated in the bottom left corner, but that does mean there's a lot of plains, there's mountains in the bottom right, you've got a swamp up in the top. It gives you a lot of space to build, and you can build quite large stuff without any, you know, terrain getting in the way and stuff. If you do need sand or snow or whatever, then it's all in the bottom left-hand corner. You can get down there fairly easily. This is part of why I want to do the railway tracks, you know, so we can get to these different biomes quite quickly. Okay, so we've arrived at, I believe this is Fergus 95's house, made out of sandstone, which took him quite some time. I think he found a vein of sandstone bricks, which he started to use. Unfortunately, I think there were some connection issues with Fergus, and for almost an hour, he was just kind of standing here, looking sadly into the waters, and just kind of drifting off. And I think a pig, unfortunately, pushed him in. It came up that he drowned, but then we didn't see him again, so I'm hoping he's okay, and maybe he'll come back at some point, but yeah, forever afraid of pigs. This is the last one. This is DNC X-Storm's house. I like the little pressure plate gate. It's quite cool. I do wonder if a creeper stands on that, will it just open the gate and wander through? I'm not sure. an absurd amount of pork there. I don't really know what. I don't know why you need a pig farm that big, but maybe he's got plans. Maybe he's going to raise up an army of pigs. You got his wheat farm over on the coast, obviously. I said to him this looked like something out of Indiana Jones, like a Mayan temple or something like that, but I don't think he really agreed with me on that one. But anyway, we'll go down, have a little look. Ooh, he's got some nice wood flooring in it. Now, last time I came in here, it was dirt and stone, I think. But yeah, again, it's something that he started to build. We haven't, as I say, we haven't had a lot of time to be building everything that people would want to, I think. So, well, he's managed to collect a fair bit, so. But yeah, that's the projects that we've got at the moment. That's the kind of starting houses and things that people are doing. There's only a few in here. We haven't had a lot of people, you know, we've had a lot of people that are interested in playing, but we haven't had a lot of people that have actually joined in fully and you know, started building stuff. I mean, literally we've got those four or five people there that have done, you know, three of those are mods as well, so. Yeah, so back in Haven in the middle of the map, and that's it. That's the intro tour of Elysium. Hopefully, I'll see a few more people joining me and joining the other guys as well, and we'll start building some big projects and things. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed it. If you're interested, then join up with the forums or send me a message on Xbox Live. Trevor's2888, like, subscribe, or comment, and thanks for listening, and I'll catch you all soon.